Hi Extra Top Family, in this video I'll show you secret places around the world and facts about them. Some are scary and some are confusing. North Sentinel Island is one of the Andaman Islands. It's home to the Sentinelese, an indigenous people in voluntary isolation. The Andaman and Nicobar Islands Protection of Aboriginal Tribes Act of 1956 prohibits travel to the island and any approach closer than 5 nautical miles, 9.26 kilometers, in order to prevent the resident tribes people from counteracting diseases to which they have no immunity. The area is patrolled by the Indian Navy. The island is a protected area of India. In 2018, the government of India excluded 29 islands, including North Sentinel, from the restricted area permit (RAP) regime until 31 December 2020 in a major effort to boost tourism. The Sentinelese have repeatedly attacked approaching vessels. This resulted in the deaths of the two fishermen in 2006 and a U.S. missionary, John Allen Chow, in 2018. John Allen Chow was an American Christian missionary who was killed by the Sentinelese, a self-isolated uncontact people, after illegally traveling to North Sentinel Island in an attempt to preach Christianity to them. The Sentinelese people are resistant outsiders and often attack anyone who comes near, and visits to the island are heavily restricted by the government. Chow was apparently shot and killed by arrows, but the cause of death can't be confirmed until his body is recovered. In addition, there was a man who spent decades befriending isolated Sentinelese tribe. The tribe, who have lived in near total isolation for tens of thousands of years, came to global attention last week after they reportedly killed a 27-year-old American would-be missionary trying to make contact with them. But Mr. Bandon, now 84, says from his experience the group are largely peace-loving and believes their fearsome reputation is unfair. He said, "I feel very sad for the death of this young man who came all the way from America, but he made a mistake. He had enough chance to save himself, but he persisted and paid with his life." Mr. Bandon first set out to visit North Sentinel Island, solely inhabited by the tribe, in 1967 as part of an expedition group. Initially, the Sentinelese hid in the jungle from their visitors, and then on later trip shot at them with arrows. He said the anthropologist would bring a selection of items along with them on their trips to try and entice contact. Mausoleum of the First Chen Emperor. No doubt thousands of statues still remain to be unearthed at this archaeological site, which was not discovered until 1974. Chen, the first unifier of China, is buried surrounded by the famous terracotta wearers. At the center of a complex designed to mirror the urban plan of the capital, Shenyang, the small figures are all different. With their horses, chariots, and weapons, they are masterpieces of realism and also of great historical interest. As the tomb of the first emperor who unified the country, is the largest in Chinese history, with a unique standard and layout and a large number of exquisite funeral objects. It testifies to the founding of the first unified empire, the Qin Dynasty, which during the 3rd BCE wielded unprecedented political, military, and economic power and advanced the social, cultural, and artistic level of the empire. Because of their exceptional technical and artistic qualities, the terracotta warriors and horses and the funerary carts in bronze are major works in the history history of Chinese sculpture prior to the reign of the Han Dynasty. The army of statues bears unique testimony to the military organization in China at the time of the Warring Kingdoms and that of the short-lived empire of a thousand generations. The direct testimony of the objects found in Siro, lances, swords, axes, halberds, bows, arrows is evident. A shocking discovery. So in 1974, a group of farmers digging wells near Yichang, China stumbled upon one of the most shocking archaeological discoveries of all time. The life-size terracotta soldier they dug out of the ground turned out to be just one of an army of thousands, each utterly unique, with individual clothing, hair, and facial features. For almost four decades, archaeologists have been excavating the site. So far, they have uncovered about 2,000 clay soldiers, but experts estimate there are more than 8,000 in total. Noah's Ark, Norway's Doomsday Seed Bank, which seeks to protect the wardrobe from natural disasters. On Monday, said it had gathered more than a million varieties as it marked its 10-year anniversary. Dubbed the Noah's Ark of Food Crops, the global seed value is located deep inside a mountain on Svalbard, a remote Arctic island in a Norwegian archipelago, and has the capacity to store up to 4.5 billion seeds. The vault currently has 967,216 varieties, as some Syrian grains were withdrawn with the aim of reintroducing local strains after the fighting in Aleppo ended. Google data centers are the large data center facilities Google uses to provide their services, which combine large drives, computer nodes organized in aisles of racks, internal and external networking, environmental controls, mainly cooling and dehumidification, and operation software, especially as concerns load balancing and fault tolerance. Google doesn't like let people inside its data centers, but it does like to make its customer feel secure about the privacy and safety of its data. That's why every few years Google provides a video that provides an overview of its data center security, which also offers brief glimpses of the company's facilities and technology for the data center nerds of the world. Area 51. Area 51 is the common name of a highly classified United States Air Force USAF facility located within the Nevada Test and Training Ground. The facility is officially called Hommy Airport KXTA or Groom Lake, named after the salt flats situated next to its airfield. The intense secrecy surrounding the base has made it the frequent subject of conspiracy theories and a center component of unidentified flying object folklore. So Area 51 refers to a map location and is the popular name of a United States Air Force base. It's at Groom Lake, a dry lake bed in the Nevada desert, 85 miles 135 kilometers north of Las Vegas. What goes on inside is extremely secret. Members of the public are kept away by warning signs, electronic surveillance, and armed guards. It's also illegal to fly over Area 51. Also, the site is now visible on satellite images. The base has runways up to 12,000 feet, 2.3 miles, 3.7 kilometers long. The Coca-Cola Armored Room. In July 1886, pharmacist John Stith Burton from Columbus, Georgia, invented the original Coca-Cola drink, which was advertised as helpful in the relief of headache, to be placed primarily on sale in drugstores as a medical beverage. When Burton continued mixing experiments and reached his goal during the month of May, the new product, as yet unnamed nor a carbonated drink, was ready for the market market and was made available for sale. Pemberton's bookkeeper, Frank Robinson, is credited with naming the product and creating its logo. Robinson chose the name Coca-Cola because of its two main ingredients, coca leaves and cola nuts, and because it sounded like an alliteration. John Pemberton had taken a break and left Robinson to make and promote, as well as sell Coca-Cola on his own. He promoted the drink with the limited budget that he had and succeeded. On July 2006, a Coca-Cola employee and two others people were arrested and charged with trying to sell trade secret information to the soft drink maker's competitor PepsiCo for $1.5 million. The receipt for Coca-Cola, perhaps the company's most closely guarded secret, was never geo-parody. Instead, the information was related to a new beverage in development. Coca-Cola executives verified that the trade secret documents in question were genuine and proprietary to the company. At least one glass vial containing a sample of a new drink was offered for sale. Court documents said the conspiracy was revealed by PepsiCo, which notified authorities when it was approached by the conspirators. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit the subscribe button before you go. Thanks for watching. Extra top, extra fun.